Hello, I'm Sheryl Balthrop, Executive Director of the Eugene Mission. Thank you for taking a moment to watch this second video message regarding new service developments at the Eugene Mission as we navigate the challenges of COVID-19. First, thank you for your prayers and well wishes. The guests and staff living and serving at the Eugene Mission very much appreciate your support. As I mentioned in the previous update, we continue to serve with a skeleton crew as our staff and volunteers at higher risk have stepped back per CDC and Oregon Health Authority guidelines. We are continuing the health and hygiene practices previously outlined and have further enhanced health and safety by taking additional action. We have had staff move out of and have converted office space into additional small group sleeping and activity quarters for guests so as to permit greater social distancing. We have limited on-campus services to residential guests and are serving our unhoused neighbors via a brand new mobile outreach service. It's so important to serve these precious folks where they are at this difficult time. We are exploring a partnership with a local community provider to obtain on-site assessment and testing so that we can promptly identify any issues and help our precious guests get the medical care they need. This will also help protect the greater community as well. Perhaps the biggest change for our guests, and for many of you listening to this message as well, is our implementation of Governor Kate Brown's Executive Order Number 20-12, the stay-at-home order, also known as shelter-in-place, which mandates staying at home except for essential trips away. As Governor Brown stated in her order, staying home both keeps you safe from infection and ensures you do not unknowingly infect others. We recognize a number of factors make our guests particularly vulnerable to COVID-19. Many are older. Over 30% of our population is over the age of 60. Many have compromised immune systems and respiratory systems. And many experience mental illness or addiction and struggle to maintain the same degree of safety, hygiene, nutrition, and ability to rest when they are away from the brick and mortar structure of the Eugene Mission. We want to do our part to help keep our guests safe and also to be a good neighbor to the broader community, particularly at this difficult time of COVID-19. Please know, though, the mood here is upbeat at the Eugene Mission. The silver lining of this challenging time is that our staff and our guests are pulling together like never before. Our guests are energized by the ability to pitch in and truly be part of a team and something meaningful. Our halls ring with joy, with the sound of the Eugene Mission van being loaded with clothing, toiletries, and various essentials as our mobile team prepares to head out to serve our unhoused neighbors around town. Our kitchen hums as guests chop vegetables and stir mighty pots for dinner. Our chapel is buzzing with a series of very small gatherings of individuals, well separated by more than 6 feet, to worship with local church service broadcasts. There is a beautiful sense of camaraderie and of purpose. God is at work in this, and we will get through it together. Now, many of you have generously asked how you can help during this challenging time. Please continue to pray for our guests and our staff. Please consider a special financial contribution to the Eugene Mission, as COVID-19 is impacting our ability to care for the most vulnerable in our community. Please mail or go online at eugenemission.org. And also, please keep those face masks and latex gloves coming. You may drop them off curbside at our kitchen by our main office, located at 1542 West First Avenue, Eugene, Oregon. We are so blessed to be able to serve and show the love of Jesus Christ at this critical time. Thank you for your support. May God bless and keep you.